Margaret Cahn Corla, I move for leave to introduce the Dublin Bay Bill, a bill from Labour which I'm introducing in order to promote a radical new vision for the protection and enhancement of the wonderful natural amenity on our doorstep that is Dublin Bay. If my bill is passed, it would establish a statutory Dublin Bay Authority charged with preserving for future generations the distinctive character of Dublin Bay and its ecology as a coastal resource. It has the aim of creating a better framework for environmental protection, for governance, and indeed for improvement and enhancement of water quality for all of those who use the bay. The idea is that it will create and strengthen a better framework for the protection of this one of these great resources that our city has, indeed really one of the greatest resources. All of us, not just those in my own constituency in Dublin Bay South, but all of us in Dublin, have strong connections to the body of water stretching from Howth to Sorrento Point. We have strong connections to the bay. It's often the first thing we see when we fly into Dublin when we're coming home. It welcomes us. It's where many of us learned to swim, sail or paddle. And of course, it's the location for the opening chapter of our greatest novel, Ulysses. I'm proud to have worked with quite a number of others in bringing forward this bill, in particular with our local councillors in Dublin Bay South, Dermot Lacey, Mary Freehill and Kevin Donoghue. And Dermot Lacey in particular has been calling for a model like this for some time. I've also worked with other swimmers at the Half Moon Club in Poolbeg, and indeed with the group that was formed in 2020, arising out of concerns about water quality in Dublin Bay, the SOS Dublin Bay Group. And their Save Our Sea petition, as many colleagues will be aware, has over 20,000 signatories. So we are aware, particularly since the start of the terrible pandemic and throughout the various COVID lockdowns, how much the bay has become a true place of refuge for year-round and seasonal sea swimmers. But all too often water quality has been poor and swimming has been under threat in the bay because of the difficulty with establishing water quality, and we know also that biodiversity and marine life in the bay is under threat as a result. So what we want to do is establish a statutory authority with a specific mandate to propose and promote policies and priorities for the protection and enhancement of the environment, of the natural habitats and wildlife, and to ensure proper monitoring and regulation of seawater quality. Membership of the authority would come from elected members of the Eastern and Midland Regional Assembly and others with a special expertise or interest in future protection of Dublin Bay. And while environmental protection would be a key priority for the new authority, it would also have a mandate to improve access and facilities around Dublin Bay. I think we're conscious there is an informal task force which has some responsibilities around Dublin Bay, but with no statutory powers and with a lack of coordination, therefore, for the protection and enhancement of this wonderful amenity. For decades, we've seen crumbling dereliction in the old Sandy Mountain Black Rock baths and really a lack of facilities for those who would like to be able to use the sea and use the bay in a more meaningful manner. We might even see a Lido with public access for all swimmers in the George's Dock if we establish a new authority with the statutory powers that this bill anticipates and envisages. And it's a statutory model we've seen working elsewhere, for example, in the east coast of the US, to enhance Chesapeake Bay, where we've seen a statutory task force established some years ago, which has preserved the future of the bay, improved water standards, and encouraged greater use of the bay by local residents and citizens. And that's the sort of community facility that we want to see established in and around Dublin Bay. That's why this bill is so important. And I should say, Taoiseach, that I brought forward a question to the Minister for the Environment, Eamon Ryan, just at the end of October on water quality in Dublin Bay, seeking to ensure a better system for monitoring water quality year-round for all of us who swim in the bay throughout the year. And the Minister himself disclosed on the floor of the House that he is also a regular sea swimmer, as am I, but that he had recently had an ear infection that he wondered might be connected to quality of water in the bay. Now, I have to say, I've never, to my knowledge, become sick as a result of poor water quality in the bay. But this is a real concern for many others with whom I swim regularly. And I know that many of us do have concerns about ongoing wastewater discharges from the Ringsend wastewater treatment plant and the potential damage also that dredging is causing to the ecosystem and the biodiversity in Dublin Bay. So it's not just about human usage of the bay. We also want to protect our marine life and our biodiversity. We do believe we need a joined up and coordinated approach to the protection and enhancement of the bay. And this bill and the statutory authority it envisages.
important first step towards realising the true potential of the Bay. I look forward, Taoiseach, to the government accepting this bill, given that it is a very important environmental purpose and I think could really garner cross-party support. And I look forward to working with colleagues and others in the new year to ensure that it will pass and to future debates on it.
Thank you, Deputy Patrick. Is the bill being opposed? The bill is not being opposed, so the motion for leave to introduce is agreed.